Are the judges ready?
Yep.
Is the negative team ready? Timer ready. My name is Mikai Meisner. My partner Keaton Johnson and I stand resolved. The federal government should abolish the death penalty. Jones was convicted of murdering a police officer in Jacksonville, Florida. Jones signed a confession statement after several hours of police interrogation, but he later claimed that the confession was coerced. In the mid-1980s, the policeman who arrested Jones and the detective who took his confession were forced out of uniform for ethical violation. The policeman was later identified by a fellow officer as an enforcer who had used torture. Many witnesses came forward pointing to another subject in the case. Today, I'll be using the following terms and definitions. First, federal, constituting a form of government in which the power is distributed between a central authority and a number of constituent territorial units. Government, the body of a person that constitutes the governing authority of a political unit or organization. Abolish, to end the observance or effect of, to completely do away with something. Death penalty. Death is a punishment given by a court of law for very serious crimes, capital punishment. Those are from Merriam-Webster Dictionary.org. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you how we win a debate. How we win the debate is by proving the stock issues. Here are the stock issues which we will absolutely prove. Significant. Whether or not the affirmative team's harms or advantages are important. Topicality. Whether or not the affirmative team stays within the boundaries of the resolution. Inherency. Whether the affirmative team harms are caused by the current policy and thus can be changed by fixing it. Solvency. Whether or not the affirmative team will solve the harms that is identified. We will clearly be able to solve the harm these stock issues through our debate today. Today I'll present to you four harms. The first harm is the death penalty costs an obnoxious amount of money. The death penalty costs an obnoxious amount of money. Quote, the defense costs for the death penalty trials in Kansas average about $400,000 per case, compared to $100,000 per case when the death penalty was not sought. PalmBeachPost.com. We are charging an outrageous amount of money to people that aren't settled with whether the death penalty is even effective. Quote, in Maryland, taxpayers paid $186 million between 1978 and 1999 to prosecute death penalty cases. The average cost per case was $3 million. Only 5 prisoners were executed during that time. TheBalance.com. Here is evidence that we would have saved families from constantly paying an obnoxious amount of money. We have a clear solution that will help a lot of taxpayers. Our second harm is it does not deter admissible crime. It does not deter admissible crime. Quote, studies have shown that murder rates, including murder of police officers, are constantly higher in states that have the death penalty, while states that abolish the death penalty have the lowest rates of police officers killed in the line of duty, EGI.org. The death penalty is supposed to deter crime, but according to this quote, it's clear that it's not deterring crime, it is raising crime. Quote, in light of the massive amount of evidence before us, I see no alternative but to conclude that capital punishment cannot be justified on the basis of its deterrent effect. Justice Marshall, U.S. Supreme Court, Furman v. Georgia. Even in the Supreme Court, they could find no proof that the death penalty has any deterrent effect whatsoever. Quote, since Kansas stopped executing, the murder rate has dropped by 44%. Amnesty.org. Here is hard cold evidence that when the death penalty was stopped, there is a clear drop in murder rate. This is a fact that we have gathered that, and it is 44%, which is a giant number. Our third harm is that people are absolutely wrongly charged. People are absolutely wrongly charged. Quote, no one should be killed because the government made a mistake. Yet 154 people on death row have been exonerated since 1976. We know that this total, which climbs steadily each year, is much lower than the actual number of people on death row who are or were innocent. One study estimates that one in every 25 defendants sentenced to death is innocent. ACLU.org. There have been over 150 people on death row who are not guilty. There are high possibilities that the number is even lower than it probably is. Quote, there are cases where prosecutors withheld exculpatory information. They knew that there are bogus pieces of evidence introduced. They knew that there were defendants who were coerced into entering a guilty plea to a crime they had not committed. DeathPenaltyProCon.org. People have withheld evidence in court cases that inevitably put innocent lives to death. Quote, since 1976, there were 18 people who were instantly convicted. DeathPenaltyInfo.org. They will argue that this isn't significant, but it is. Judges, if you lost your parent or your spouse instantly, would you just shake it off and say it wasn't significant? Of course not. One life is clearly too much. We will provide a plan that will make sure we do not let one innocent person die. Our fourth harm is law enforcement doesn't think it works. Law enforcement doesn't think it works. The vast majority of law enforcement professionals surveyed agreed that capital punishment does not deter violent crime. crime. A survey of police chiefs nationwide found they ranked the death penalty lowest always to reduce violent crime. They ranked decreasing the number of police officers, reducing drug abuse, creating a better economy with more jobs, higher than the death penalty is the best way to reduce violence, ACLU.org. According to professionals, they don't believe it is sufficient for reducing crime. There are better ways to deter crime without killing people, and we will use one of those better ways. Our plan, mandate. We should abolish the death penalty, and we should punish them with life in prison without parole. In addition, we will increase the number of police and accomplish what the death penalty was supposed to do, but failed at, deter crime. We have a clear and obvious choice, where we could increase the number of police and deter crime. Also, we would save money and innocent people would not be killed each year. Our agency is the Department of Justice, our enforcement is the Department of Justice, our funding is the taxes that you pay for the death penalty would be more than enough to pay for the increase in police and then some. Today we will give you two advantages. Advantage one, increasing the police will undoubtedly deter crime. Increasing the police will undoubtedly deter crime. Quote, during high alert periods, the Washington, D.C. police force would mobilize extra officers, especially in and around the Capitol Square, centered on the National Mall. Using daily crime data, they found that the level of crime decreased significantly on high alert days, and the decrease was especially concentrated on the National Mall. Vox.com. We have tried this before, and with data, we are able to clearly see that we can reduce crime without the risk of innocent people dying. Quote, increasing police in the 1990s brought crime down by about 5%. This could range from 0 to 10%. TheAtlantic.com. Yet again, we have facts that increasing police certainly deters crime, and we have a clear way, we have a way better chance to deter crime than we would with the death penalty. Our second advantage is that increasing the police, in fact, does cost less than the death penalty. Quote, the average police officer's salary in Minneapolis, Minnesota is $61,100 as of August 27, 2020. But the range typically falls between $57,000 and $66,500. Salary.com. You could almost get as much as for 8 police officers for only one case and even conviction. We would be helping lower taxes and deter crime if we increased the number of police and got rid of the death penalty. We have hard cold evidence of how this would work instead of merely opinions. In conclusion, my partner Keaton Johnson and I, Mikai Moss, are for the resolution the United States should change its penal code to abolish the death penalty. We ask you to vote for the resolution. Thank you, judges. I'm ready for cross-exam.
When you said on your first proof, on your second proof, it doesn't deter, do you have any stats for that?
Yep, in Canada, when the death penalty was not sought, the murder rate dropped 44%.
Alright, do you have any stats you can show us?
I just said it.
Physical proof, okay.
There we go.
Can't people be wrongly charged into... Okay, wait, hold on. So you said that, how many people did you say were wrongly convicted?
18. I know that's a very 18? Big number.
Okay. Compared to how many people go to life imprisonment? How many people go to life imprisonment, do you think? Do you know? Sorry.
I don't.
You said... law enforcement doesn't think it will work. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's an opinion? Or do you know that's an opinion?
Well, that's what the law enforcement thinks.
All right, thank you for your answer.
Okay.
Okay, are the judges ready? Is the timer ready? Yes, I am. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, judges and audience. My name is Ethan Friesner, my partner Josiah Paul, and I stand against the resolution that the U.S. federal government should abolish the death penalty. A judge handed Brandon Howell 5 consecutive life sentences without parole Thursday for a series of killings 6 years ago. I can't say today was a good day, said Kara Taylor, the granddaughter of two of the victims. There's no good outcome here, but it's nice to have closure. Taylor had a victim's impact statement in court about the slayings of her grandparents, George and Ann Taylor. According to court testimony, Howell fatally beat the Taylors to steal the elderly couple's car. They died in the hospital after being taken off life support. Kathy Hurst also spoke in court about her husband, Daryl, and mother-in-law, Lorene. Daryl had been on an errand to help Lorene get a light bulb when Howell shot and killed them. Howell previously had served prison time for a 2000 conviction of kidnapping, assault, robbery, and cruelty to animals. He was also accused of the 1998 murders of two shiny teenagers. And to think, the affirmative team thinks that this man should continue to live after brutally taking the life of not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, but not six, but seven lives. The definitions, we agree with the definitions. But the affirmative team brought up the innocence that many people are wrongly convicted. However, we say that not everyone is wrongly convicted. And we know this because DNA testings are over 99% effective. And even if DNA testings and other scientific methods didn't exist, the trial and appeal process is so thorough, it is almost next to impossible to convict an innocent person. Because remember, a jury of 12 members must unanimously decide there's not even a reasonable doubt that the person is guilty, beyond a reasonable doubt that the person is guilty. Quote from Ballad Politics. This is important because the chances of someone getting wrongly convicted are extremely low. After all, DNA testings are almost 100% accurate. And 12 unbiased judges must all think the person is guilty as charged. The affirmative team also brought up that the death penalty does not deter crime. However, we think it does deter crime. And we know this because according to deathpenaltyinfo.org, a chart shows that national murder rates from 1970 to 2017, murder rates almost decreased by almost 5 murders a year from 1970. This obviously shows a decrease in crime. The affirmative team also brought up cost. They said that death penalty is obnoxiously annoying. Because in the year 2013, federal judges imposed a sentence of life imprisonment without parole on 153 offenders. Another 168 offenders received a sentence of a specific term of years that was so long that it could be a practical effect of being a life sentence. Later in the source, it says, with 39 death penalty cases in 2013, this marks only the second time in nearly two decades that the United States executed less than 40 people. Death penalty cases, also further in the source, death penalty cases cost were counted through to the execution. Death penalty cases cost $1.26 million. Non-death penalty cases, such as life imprisonment without parole, were counted through the end of incarceration, and the total was $740,000, amnestyusa.org. This said, the total amount of money spent on life imprisonment cases is $113,220,000. This is within 2013 with the 153 offenders. But then, while death penalty cases were only $49,140,000, making life imprisonment $64 million more than the death penalty. And their plan, their mandate was life imprisonment without parole. And this obviously goes against the cost, because life imprisonment costs more than the death penalty. Then the advantage to innocence, the affirmative team, again, they said innocence faced the many innocent people death row. But according to, deterrence. The affirmative team said that crime is not lowered because of the death penalty. However, we say we know this because the recent studies using panel data techniques have confirmed that what we have learned decades ago. Capital punishment does, in fact, save lives and deter crime. Vantage 5, the affirmative team said that the death penalty is quite expensive. However, we say that is hypocritical because we know that the study concluded it costs the state an average of $45,000 each year to incarcerate a prisoner serving his life sentence without parole. This is much cheaper than the death penalty. So the death penalty obviously ensures no one is wrongly convicted, it obviously deters violent crime, and is cheaper than life imprisonment without parole. Because of these proofs and the advantages to them, I now would urge the judges to reject the affirmative team resolution and maintain the status quo. Thank you. And I'm ready for cross-examination. The phone turned off, so I have no channel left.
Okay. So, you had a chart about deterrence.
Yes.
What year was that?
It was from 1980 to 2017.
You said something different. What was the year? From deathpenaltyinfo.org?
Oh, 1970, 2017.
Okay, do you have any quotes about increasing the police, or do you agree with us?
I do not have any quotes against it, but okay. I do not agree with it.
Did you have any quotes, or did you attack harmful, or do you agree with it?
What was harmful?
It was about the cops do not think that the death penalty does work.
So the law enforcement one?
Mm-hmm.
I did not have any quotes for it, but yeah, I do think it's
harmful. And you did not clarify that your partner was going to talk about any of those things in his 2NC, correct?
Yes.
So he cannot bring it up in his 2NC, correct?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. What is the purpose of the death penalty?
To make a system for criminals, for a system for justice for criminals who did wrong, including murder and violent crimes like that, to be put to justice.
So the sole purpose of the death penalty is just another form of punishment?
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Do you think $4 billion is a lot of money?
Yes.
Okay. Do you believe that it is right if someone has had evidence withheld from the court if they can be convicted of the death penalty?
Say that again.
If evidence is withheld from the court and they are convicted of the death penalty, is that right?
No.
Okay, no further questions.
Now we can see you, Steph.
Okay, are the judges ready?
I am.
Yep.
Audience? Megan's team? Not ready?
Yes.
Nobody can really say with a straight face this is a system that is working. Paula Mitchell. She is right. This is a flawed system, and it's a mystery why we still even have it around. As my partner demonstrated, there's some key problems with the death penalty. It costs an obnoxious amount of money, there's absolutely no deterrence effect, it's unstable because people are wrongly convicted, and police, who are experts on the subject, say it doesn't work. I'll prove to you today that our harms and plan are solvent, inherent, topical, and significant. My outline will be I'll address the stock issue and then go on to show how each harm agrees with that stock issue. To review, significancy is defined as whether or not the affirmative's harms are important. Our harms are most definitely significant. Harm one, cost. The cost doesn't affect just a few people, but millions. Quote, California doesn't punish the killers. It punishes the innocent, the school kids, university students, the elderly, the poor, the taxpayers. Source, George Skelton. Summary, in California alone, there were 39.51 million people. Our harms were significant for another reason. The fact that the death penalty doesn't deter puts all citizens at risk. Harm two, deterrence. Quote, the South, which accounts for more than 80% of the country's execution, also has the highest murder rate of any region in the country. If anything, the police indicted the violence, or the death penalty indicted violence rather than curbed it. ACLU. There are 114,555,744 people in the southern United States. If we kept the death penalty, all of those people will constantly be more at risk of being murdered than if the death penalty were to be abolished. Our third harm is also significant, because we are not just convicting a few innocent people, but many. Harm three, innocence. Quote, a recent study by Columbia Law University found that 2/3 of all capital trials contain serious errors. When the cases were retried, over 80% of the defendants were not sentenced to death, and 7% were completely acquitted. Source, Michigan State University and Death Penalty Information Center. Summary, 80% of the defendants were not given death as a punishment. That is very significant. Our fourth harm is also significant because it's concerning the opinion of people who are law enforcement on this subject, and the negative agrees with us. Harm four, law enforcement professionals don't think it works. Quote, give a law enforcement professional like me that $250 million and I will show you how to reduce crime. The death penalty isn't anywhere on my list. Source, Death Penalty Information Center, James Abbott. If law enforcement professionals think the death penalty doesn't work, we should take their word for it. Our harms are significant. Inherency is defined as whether or not the affirmative's harms are caused by the current policy and thus can be fixed by changing it. The outrageous cost of the death penalty is most definitely caused by it, and we can fix it by abolishing it. Harm one, cost. A new study in California revealed that the cost of the death penalty in the state has been over $4 billion since 1978. Study considered pretrial costs, trial costs, cost of automatic appeals,
state habeas corpus petitions, cost of federal habeas corpus petitions, and cost of incarceration on death row. Source, Death Penalty Information Center. When we take into account all the parts of the death penalty to calculate the cost, not just one stage of the trial or how much the drug costs, we are given staggering numbers. The fact that the death penalty doesn't deter murder is also something that needs to be fixed. Harm two, deterrence. A report released by the prestigious National Research Council of National Academies, based on review of more than three decades of research, concludes that studies claiming a deterrent effect on murder rates from the death penalty are fundamentally flawed. Source, Death Penalty Information Center. Here's a study that's taken over three decades of work, and it concludes that there is no deterrence effect. The unjustness of killing innocent people is also caused by the death penalty and can be fixed by abolishing it. Harm three, innocence. Since 1973, over 156 people have been released from death row in 26 states because of innocence. Nationally, at least one person is exonerated for every 10 that are executed. ACLU. The death penalty is causing innocent people to die. The death penalty is also infringing our law enforcement. The money it's using up should be put towards more officers. Harm 4. Law enforcement professionals don't think it works. Quote, a 2008 study found that 88% of the nation's leading criminologists believe the death penalty is not an effective deterrent. Source, Death Penalty Information Center. The reason law enforcement professionals are unhappy is they know from firsthand experience that the death penalty doesn't work. Our harms are inherent. Solvency now is defined as whether or not the affirmative's case will solve the harms it's identified. First, I want to look into how our plan will solve harms one and two, cost and deterrence. Quote, the General Assembly Officer of Physical Analysis, the death penalty costs the state an estimated $4 million per year to maintain. Repeal is expected to save the state $850,000 per year in the next 2 years, and office expects that amount to grow to $5 million in subsequent years. Connecticut abolishes the death penalty. By abolishing the death penalty, the state has saved millions of dollars, and now let's look at its murder rate. In 2012, Connecticut abolished the death penalty for future crimes, ending the state's death penalty. Then, murders in Connecticut dropped below 100 for the first time in a decade. www.corrent.com and death penalty info. Connecticut should be an example to all of us. By abolishing the death penalty, it will not only save millions of dollars, but it will save lives. Moving on to harm three, the death penalty convicts innocent people and thinks nothing of it. The rate of false conviction of criminal defendants who are sentenced to death reveals that the number of innocent people are more likely than double those actually exonerated and freed from death row. Of the people that are released from death row, double that amount is wrongly killed. By abolishing the death penalty, we would save lives. The negative may argue that people may still be accused, but as Freddie Lee Pitt said, you can release an innocent man from prison, but you can't release him from the grave. I'm sure the judges would agree with me. Finally, the fourth harm, law enforcement professionals don't think it works. Our plan will resolve this because we listen to law enforcement professionals and find what they really need. Quote, a new national survey of police chiefs from around the country discredits the repeated assertion that the death penalty is an important law enforcement tool. While politicians have extolled the importance of capital punishment in fighting crime, they have failed to assess the actual priorities of those in law enforcement. So what are their real needs then? A survey of police chiefs nationwide found they ranked increasing the number of police officers higher than the death penalty as the best way to reduce violence, ACLU. So professionals say the best way to reduce crime is to get more police force. This is exactly what our plan is suggesting. Now, the affirmative claim the death penalty is cheaper than life in prison. However, quote, studies of the death penalty system, the largest in the US, have revealed that a death sentence costs at least 18 times as much as a sentence of life without parole would cost, deathpenalty.org. In fact, the death penalty is not cheaper. Also, our plan will solve the problem of deterrence because, quote, using a variety of specifications, we show that an increase in police presence about 50% leads to statistically and economically significant decrease in the level of crime in order of 15%. Death penalty curriculum. So we can see how easily our plan and the police presence will deter crime. The negative also said that the death penalty is just another punishment. So if it's just another punishment system that we have and it has all these problems, why are we keeping it? So judges, I urge you to vote for the resolution so we can get rid of this wrecked system. As I've irrefutably demonstrated, our harms and plan are significant, inherent, solvent, and topical. Thank you. Now ready for cross-examination.
Okay. There you go. Ready? Okay, first of all, do you have credentials on Paula Mitchell?
Yes, she wrote a book called Executing the Will of Voters, a roadmap to mend or end the California legislators' multi-billion-dollar...
Okay, thank you. Okay, how many people have been wrongly convicted?
wrongly convicted?
Yes.
I do not.
Or innocent.
How many total, or?
Yeah.
For the death penalty?
Yep. No, yes.
I do not have the exact number of how many people are have been wrongly convicted.
Okay.
Actually, wait, I do, sorry. I just thought of that.
Anyways, I also, you said that I agreed with the officers. I did not agree with the officers that they said it didn't work, but I just didn't have any quotes for it, so I just want to make that
clear. Is that a question?
No, I just want to make that clear. Okay, and would you agree that there's more life imprisonment without parole cases than there are death penalty cases?
I'm sorry, just say that again.
Would you agree there's more life imprisonment without parole cases rather than death penalty cases?
I do not know.
Okay. And do you think there's innocent people put on life imprisonment without parole?
Yes, but as the quote I showed,
so
you can release an innocent
man
from prison,
are
but you can't release somebody that's already been killed.
Do you think the police are giving their opinions when they say, like, just give me, like...
I think they are giving their opinions, however,
they're
experts
opinions.
On the
okay,
subject.
Thanks. Okay, do you have any proof that your alternate plan will work?
Yes, as my partner showed, in his advantages, and as I showed about Connecticut, how they reduce the number of murders and they reduce cost, and my partner showed about Washington, D.C., them reducing the number of crimes when they had more police force. And I also showed that in my deterrence.
So you say that a death penalty case costs more, right?
Yes.
Okay, but then there are many more, there's hundreds probably more of life imprisonment without parole cases than death penalty cases, is that correct?
Did you show any evidence for that?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
I don't
have
no
further
questions.
Okay.
I can't tell this
thing.
Sorry.
We're
running out of time, so we're
going to
have to go off and come back.
Are you
going to
do prep time?
Right now.
Are the judges ready?
Nope.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is the timer ready? Yes. Is it? Oh, is the affirmative team ready?
Yep.
Nice. So, I can't really bring up any proofs, as you may have noticed, but my partner already proved that the innocence, deterrence, and cost was accurate. So I can't bring up any proofs, might as well bring up the advantages. The first advantage for innocence is the affirmative team said many innocents face death row. However, we say that is inaccurate. We know this because according to stats we found from the Death Penalty Information Center, 20 people were wrongfully executed. Deterrence. The affirmative team said that crime is not lowered because of the death penalty. However, we know this because the recent studies using panel data techniques have confirmed what we have learned decades ago. Capital punishment does, in fact, save lives. And cost. The affirmative team said that the death penalty is quite expensive. However, we say that is hypocritical. We know this because a study concluded it costs the state an average of $45,000 each year to incarcerate a prisoner serving a sentence of life without parole. In conclusion, the death penalty obviously ensures no one is wrongly convicted, deters violent crime, and is cheaper than life imprisonment. Because of these proofs and the advantages of them, I now urge the judges to reject the affirmative team's resolution and maintain the status quo. Thank you. I now stand for cross. This turned off.
What was the first advantage you talked about?
Innocence.
Okay, and what was the quote?
We know this because according to stats we found from the Death Penalty Information Center, 20 people were wrongfully executed.
Okay, and so that the death penalty does kill innocent people, correct? You said 20 people were innocently killed? So it does kill innocent people, correct?
Correct.
Alright, and do you think that it is important that innocent people died?
Can you rephrase that?
Do you think that it's
important that innocent people die?
Yes.
I also think it's important that...
Do you think that it's important that innocent people died? It's a yes or no question.
Well, I also think it's important that...
No, is it... Please answer my question. Is it important that innocent people died?
It is important that innocent people
okay, thank
go
you.
To life in prison.
Then, all right. So, is the death penalty supported by the police?
Is the death penalty supported by the police?
Yes.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Not supported by the law.
Did you bring up any examples or evidence that our plan will not work? Examples from prior things that have happened?
You mean from, like, what my partner said?
Yeah, for your whole case.
You mean you want me to bring up...
I'm just asking, did you bring up any evidence for prior examples of if our plan worked?
Well, we said stuff. Said
any examples, though, of actual things, people who have done this before? Did you bring up any examples that it did not work?
Brought up some stories and things, such as...
For innocence. But did he... But people who have actually tried this plan, did you bring up any evidence that people who have tried this plan found that it didn't work?
Tried the plan? What's the plan?
Our plan.
Your plan? What is your plan?
You didn't ask for one I see.
Right. Just kidding.
Okay, so you're agreeing with our plan because you didn't bring up
it. I'm not sure.
All right. And then did, in either of your constructives, did you bring up stock issues?
Pardon?
In either of your constructive arguments, did you bring up stock issues? Or in any of your cross exams?
I don't think we brought them up.
Okay. Can you please restate that?
I don't know. I think we implied them, but I don't think we brought them up.
So you did not bring up stock issues, correct?
Not entirely.
Okay. No further questions.
Need to press start. On the time.
Yep. Okay. Are the judges ready?
Yeah, ready.
Is the time on?
Yes.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, judges and audience. My name is Ethan Friesner, and my partner Josiah Paul and I stand for the resolution that the U.S. federal government should abolish the death penalty. As J.R.R. Tolkien once said, many that live deserve death, and some that die deserve life. How can you give it to them? Then do not be too eager to deal out death and judgment. The death penalty. Just saying those two words together makes my stomach churn. Who in their right mind can even consider taking one's life as a punishment? So before we start, I want to go over some key terms we will be using throughout the debate today. The first one, federal government. The national government of a federated state. Source, dictionary.com. Definition, to abolish, to do away with. Source, dictionary.com. Next definition, death penalty, punishment by death for a crime, also by dictionary.com. And next definition, government. The body of persons that constitutes the governing authority of a political unit or organization. Source, Merriam-Webster.com. So now that we've gone over our key terms that we'll be using, now let's look at the major problems that are in the status quo today. So, starting off with harm more. It costs more to implement the death penalty. Quote from Susquehanna University report found that, on average, across all 50 states, a death row inmate costs $1.12 million more than a general population inmate. In July 2018, there were 2,738 inmates on death row. That's almost $3 billion additional expenses than if they had all been sentenced to life in prison instead. Source, TheBalance.com. Second harm, race is a factor in the death penalty. Quote, in Louisiana, the odds of a death sentence were 97% higher for those whose victim was white rather than for those whose victim was black. Pearson Radlett, Louisiana Law Review, 2011. Harm three, many people have been wrongly convicted. Quote, DNA tests raised serious doubts about the conviction of Claude Jones, executed in Texas in 2000. The test revealed that a strand of hair found at the scene of a liquor store shooting did not belong to Jones, as was originally implied by the prosecution. Instead, the hair belonged to the victim. Jones was executed for the murder of the store's owner. The strand of hair was the only piece of physical evidence that placed Jones at the scene of the crime. Source, deathpenaltyinfo.org. Summary, there are several documented cases where DNA testing showed that innocent people were put to death by the government. Harm four, the death penalty is not deter crime. Quote, according to a survey of the former and present presidents of the country's top academic criminological societies, 88% of these experts reject the notion that the death penalty acts as a deterrent to murder. Source files, deathpenaltyinfo.org, 2020. Harm five, the death penalty targets poor people. Nearly all 3,500 Americans awaiting execution on death row today have low-income backgrounds. Source deathmoney.procon.org, the NACP. Form 6 eliminates the possibility of rehabilitation. Quote, instead of allowing individuals an opportunity to make amends in some way, it automatically assumes that nothing can be done about that person. Source, Tana.org, 2018. So after we've gone over harms, we can see there's obviously major problems in the current system. So let's see the solution in our plan. So the affirmative team will be solving these problems by a significant reform of our policies towards moving from the death penalty to life imprisonment without parole. So our mandate was life sentence without parole. The agency will be the U.S. Congress and federal government. Enforcement will be police and military. And then the funding will come from state taxes. So now that we've already gone over the harms and our solution to the problems, let's look at the benefits that will come once our plan is implemented. So we will see, first off, there are 6 major advantages. First one being, we can use the money in other ways. Quote, by redirecting death penalty dollars in a careful and targeted way, we can reduce crime while improving our communities and saving money. Source, NCADP.org, 2015. Advantage 2, racism will be reduced. Quote, people of color have accounted for a disproportionate 43% of total executions since 1976, and 55% of those currently awaiting execution. Source, ACLU.org, 2020. Our third advantage, less innocent people will be killed. Quote, as of October 2015, we have executed over 1,414 individuals in this country since 1976. 156 individuals have been exonerated from death row, that is, found to be innocent and then released since 1973. In other words, for every 10 people who have been executed since the death penalty was reinstated in the U.S., one person has been set free. NCADP.org 2015. Fourth advantage, there are better ways to deter crime. Quote, a survey of police chiefs nationwide found they ranked the death penalty lowest among ways to reduce violent crime. They ranked increasing the number of police officers, reducing drug abuse, and creating a better economy with more jobs higher than the death penalty as the best ways to reduce violence. Source, ACLU.org, 2020. The fifth advantage will be nobody will feel targeted. As Supreme Court Justice Harry Blackmun put it, even under the most sophisticated death penalty statutes, race continues to play a major role in determining who shall live and who shall die. Source, NCADP.org, 2020. And our last advantage is more people will be able to rehabilitate. Quote, there are criminals who prefer to live outside of the rules that society sets. These individuals may never be rehabilitated. The death penalty completely eliminates that possibility from the equation. Source, Vitana.org, 2018. So, in conclusion, we can obviously see there are some major harms in the status quo. I'll go over them. One, it costs more to implement the death penalty. Two, race is a factor in the death penalty. Then, many people have been wrongly convicted. The death penalty does not deter crime. The death penalty targets poor people, and it completely eliminates the possibility of rehabilitation. And so, we have looked at our plan to solve these problems. Our mandates will be life sentence without parole. Our agency will be the U.S. Congress and federal government, will be enforced by police and military, and the funding will come from state taxes. So in conclusion, our plan not only will work, will also give us several benefits, such as we can use the money in other ways. Racism will be reduced. Less innocent people will be killed. Or there are better ways to deter crime. Nobody will feel targeted, and more people will be able to rehabilitate. It is because we believe in the importance of the federal government and abolishing the death penalty, that my partner Josiah Paul and I, Ethan Friesen, urge the judges to vote for the resolution. I'm now ready for press.
May I have a copy of the one you see? So you see.
Speak up, okay.
Do you have any, what is your definition of rehabilitation?
We do not have that in the definitions.
Okay, thank you. Now, what is your advantage? I believe it's 4.
There are better ways to deter crime.
What's advantage 3?
Less innocent people will be killed.
Okay, what's advantage 5?
No, we were targeted.
Okay, so are you That is different from your harm? Are you combining those, or are those separate?
No, our harm was that the death penalty targets poor people.
Okay, so those are different.
No, because the death penalty, the harm five is that the death penalty target people, and the advantage will be that nobody will feel targeted.
Do you have any proof that your plan will work from past experiences?
No.
Okay. Do you have any actual numbers or studies or facts that you have there's a deterrence in that there's no deterrence with the death penalty?
That there is no deterrence?
Yep, that there is no deterrence.
Yes.
That was just a graph about what people think. Do you have any actual facts that there is no deterrence?
No. Besides that, most
opinions.
There's
no facts. Alright, thank you. Do you have actual numbers or a study that shows how many people have been innocently put to death?
I do not have them on, in paper, but I do have... In my mind, there's
you
been many cases, such as, I can name a few. There's Carlos de Luna, Cantu, Cameron Todd, Willingham.
So you have three.
Well, no, I
okay.
can.
So, do you believe that imprisonment will be a better deterrent?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Do you believe that abolishing the death penalty result in overall lower deaths? Do you believe that abolishing of the death penalty will result in overall lower deaths?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Do you believe more money will be saved with your plan?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. No further questions. And then we will take 3 minutes of prep time.
Good morning. My partner, Makai Meisner, and I, Keaton Johnson, oppose the resolution. The United States federal government should abolish the death penalty. Although both the affirmative and the negative agree that the death penalty has some problems, we disagree on how to fix them. The affirmative believe the status quo should be abolished. However, we believe the status quo should be altered, not abolished. The first thing I want to clear up is that the affirmative said a few things that I didn't agree with. Capital punishment. I would like to redefine. Capital punishment is the legal, under the United States federal government, crime justice system. It can be imposed for treason, espionage, murder, and large-scale drug trafficking. And they also claimed a few things about the death penalty that I did not agree with. They claimed the death penalty was racist. You may say the death penalty is racist because African Americans only make up 13% of the population, and yet they are sentenced to the death penalty more. But, quote, black or African Americans make up 57.9% of murder and non-illegitimate manslaughter. Source, FBI.gov. Even if the death penalty was racist, it wouldn't be a reason to abolish the death penalty. Quote, writing on the majority for the opinion for the Supreme Court, Judge Powell held that the statistical studies on race by themselves were an insufficient basis for overturning the death penalty. Source, deathpenaltycurriculum.org. They also claim people are wrongly accused. However, significancy. This is not significant enough to deserve our attention. Quote, 1,526 people executed since 1976, and there were only 18 people who were probably innocent and convicted. That is 1.179%. The Declaration of Independence, a document our country is founded on, states prudence indeed will dictate that the governments long established should not be changed for light and transient causes. This is not a big enough deal to pursue further. They also claim the death penalty doesn't deter crime. However, solvency, the death penalty does in fact deter crime. Quote, lawmakers in New Hampshire voted Thursday to abolish the death penalty. Then we see New Hampshire's 32 homicides in 2019 were the most seen in decades. Source, WashingtonPost.com. And unionleader.com. Solvency. Abolishing the death penalty will hurt us even more because the death penalty protects us. Quote, using a panel set of over 3,000 countries from 1977 to 1996, Professor Hashem Dezebeksh, Paul R. Rubin, and Joanna M. Shepherd of Emory University found that each execution on average results in 18 fewer murders. Source, Mal Hughes and David, the death penalty ensures crime and saves lives. Quote, what gets little noticed, however, is a series of academic studies over the last half dozen years that claim to settle a once highly debated argument whether the death penalty acts as a deterrent to murder. Analysis says, yes, they come between 3 and 18 lives that be saved from each execution of the convicted killer. Source, www.foxnews.com. Now that I have shown that, in fact, the death penalty does deter murder, I want to bring up a few things the affirmative claim or advantages of the plan. I believe that these advantages, when looked at through the right lens, will appear their true form of disadvantages. Their plan will not work. They claim that it will cost less, less innocent people will die, and there will be less crime, and that our system is less racist. My partner will also go after their other groups. They claim our costs will go down. Although they may, at what cost? Our lives? Illinois' moratorium on executions in 2000 led to 150 additional homicides over the 4 following years, according to a 2006 study by professors of the University of Hudson, source CBN News. Quote, according to the Death Penalty Information Center, the average cost of the case without capital punishment is $740,000. For cases where death penalty is sought by prosecutors, the average of the case of the cost is $1.26 million. Source, vaitena.org. Summary, the case that seeks the death penalty is about double the amount of a trial that doesn't seek the death penalty on average. With 34 executions per year on average since 1976, if we use statistics from the Illinois poll that we will have doubled the amount of acts punishable by death, we will double the trials. So even though the trials will cost less, we will have more of them, so it will equate to the exact same amount. Another reason the idea of altering, not abolishing the death penalty is innocent people. They claim more innocent people will, as a result of the death penalty, but once again, if we look, will not die as a result of, oh, sorry. They claim more innocent people will, as a result of the death penalty, die. But once again, if we look at this situation through the right lens, we will see a different picture. As the data shows, the death penalty reduces murder. How can the affirmative claim that the innocent lives will be saved when murder rates will shoot up as innocent individuals die in the streets because murderers no longer need to be wary of punishment? Even though the thought of murder growing with like weeds is sickening, that's not all. Their plan will produce even more deaths than just on the streets. Stock issue solvency. There will be more deaths, not less, with their plans for other reasons. Quote, Tycon was sentenced to a death by a jury of his peers and had been on death row for 30 years after exhausting all of his appeals at both state and federal level. Cox, while on his death row, attempted a violent takeover of Supermax Adjustment Center at St. Quentin with goals to kill as many guards as possible. DeathPenaltyProCon.org. Finally, they claim that they'll be less racist, but quote, African solvency. The punishment system will still be racist even if the death penalty isn't abolished today. Inherently, the death penalty doesn't cause racism, but it is subject to it. Quote, African Americans are still 5 times more likely to be in prison than white people and Hispanics, nearly twice as likely. And both imbalances are wholly unacceptable. TheBaltimoreSun.com. Apparently, the Supreme Court thinks the same thing. Writing for the majority of the opinion of the Supreme Court, Justice Powell held the statistical studies on race by themselves were an insufficient basis for overturning the death penalty. Quote, writing the majority for the Supreme, instead of abolishing the death penalty, let's revise it. We can reduce costs by giving less appeals but requiring eyewitness, video evidence, or DNA evidence. With that money saved, we can add more police forces. Imagine how lower crime would be with the death penalty, more police, and quicker punishments all working together. Quote, the imposition of the death penalty is extremely expensive because it allows for endless appeals at the expense of taxpayers, including the families of the victims. Many of these cases go on for so long that the heinous crime is forgotten or the witnesses actually die. Legislators should be working not to abolish the death penalty, but to find ways to make it more cost effective. I am all for any effort to completely eliminate any doubt concerning the death penalty, DNA tests, certainly. Certification of eyewitness accounts, once again, certainly. Whatever is required, but once again, it has been determined that beyond any reasonable doubt, we the people owe them the right to a speedy trial, unencumbered by dragging out the process endlessly at the taxpayer's expense. The effectiveness of the death penalty is greatly compromised when it's not used. There needs to be certainty attached to what makes it effective, and that hasn't happened. ResearchGate.net. So let's look at what happened if we implemented some of these ideas. Speeding up executions would strengthen the deterrent effect. For every 2.7 years cut from the time spent on death row, one murder would be prevented, according to a 2004 study by Emory University, Associated Press. During high alert periods, Washington, D.C. police would formalize mobile extra officers, especially in and during around the Capitol Square, centered on the National Mall. Using daily crime data, they found that the level of crime decreased significantly, the case for hiring more police officers. This matters to everyone, because if the death penalty is abolished, our country will be filled with murder. We will not be able to trust people, because treason will no longer be punishable by death, and drug dealers will infiltrate and destroy our people. This is not something that will only affect a few people, but everyone. This is so please vote against the resolution on behalf of our country. Okay, there we go.
Okay, so at your beginning for like your agreement to screen, you said that the death penalty has problems, right?
Correct.
Okay. And then you said we both agree that the death penalty has problems.
It has some problems, yes.
Okay. And for our definition, we did not have capital punishment. We had death penalty. So.
Okay.
Did you have any dates for your sources?
Yes, we
did.
Would you like for all of them? All you want dates for all sources? Okay.
I'll keep it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and you said the death penalty. Oh, wait, sorry. You said blacks are 5 times more likely to be in prison than you. Okay, and then, did you say that racism does not matter?
I did not say that.
And also for, you mentioned Fox News. Is that a fact or is that an opinion?
For what source? For what quote was it?
I forgot what quote, but you said Fox News. But, so would that be like a factor opinion? Right? Did they have like any stats behind that?
Let's look on my list. Because
would that could be considered a fact or an opinion?
I'm not sure. They didn't say.
Okay. That's all.
Yeah. Make sure you speak up real loud.
Are the judges ready?
Yeah.
My armor is ready. As my partner has previously said, Ethan, we stand for the resolution that the U.S. government should abolish the death penalty. It costs more to implement the death penalty. Give a law enforcement professional like me that $250 million, and I'll show you how to reduce crime. The death penalty isn't anywhere on my list. Death Penalty Information Center, source Death Penalty Information Center, James Abbott, police chief. My second proof is race is a factor in the death penalty. In Louisiana, the odds of a death sentence were 97% higher for those whose victim was white than for those whose victim was black. My third proof is many people have been wrongly convicted. Since 1973, more than 170 people have been released from death row with evidence of their innocence. My fourth proof is the death penalty doesn't deter crimes. The vast majority of law enforcement professionals surveyed agree that capital punishment does not deter violent crime. A survey of police chiefs nationwide found they ranked the death penalty lowest among ways to reduce violent crime. The death penalty targets poor people. The death penalty is imposed in the United States upon the poorest, most powerless, most marginalized people in the society. Quote Stephen B. Bright, professor of practice at Georgia State College. And my sixth proof is it eliminates the possibility of rehabilitation. Capital punishment doesn't rehabilitate the prisoner and return them to society. BBC. And I am ready for cross-ex.
So you have in your 1AC and your 2AC, do you have credentials for anything?
You mean like sources?
The sources, you have the credentials, like where they got their degree, what?
Yes, actually, for some. Well, what do you mean like where they were?
So for the one that says nearly all 3,500 Americans waiting execution on death row today have low income backgrounds. Your source with the deathpenaltyprocom.org, but you had no credentials for it.
Is that from 1AC?
Yes, that is from 1AC. Do you have credentials for that?
Oh, that, they did not provide credentials for it.
So, do you have credentials for any of your other things?
In some of them, but not.
But not all of them. Okay. And then, for any of your, for all of your proofs, do you have any studies or actual numbers? You made claims that things were a certain way, but do you have any actual studies that show actual numbers and percentages?
Well, we do have these graphs, which are from actual court cases and such.
But did you share those in any of your 1AC or 2AC?
Some stuff is from them, but not all of it.
So you didn't have any studies?
Partially.
Okay. And innocence and rehabilitation were your third and fifth proof, or sorry, your third and sixth proof. Innocence and rehabilitation. So, what did you define innocence as?
I do not think we defined that in our definitions.
And what did you define rehabilitation as?
We do not have that in our definitions either.
And so, rehabilitation and innocence, since you don't have the, you don't have anything for them. Okay, not for the question.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, judges and audience.
Speak up, please.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, judges and audience. Are the judges ready? Mm-hmm. Is the affirmative team ready?
Sir.
Is the timer ready? My name is Mikai Meisner. My partner, Keaton Johnson, and I stand against the resolution. The United States should change its penal code to abolish the death penalty. The affirmative team states that the penal code needs to be abolished for six reasons. The first harm, the death penalty doesn't cost too much, is insignificant and inherent because, quote, in 2011, the average cost of a drug used in lethal injection was just $83.55 per dose, according to why the death penalty costs more than life in prison. This is clearly significant, because $83 is not a significant amount of number for us to get rid of the death penalty. They argue that we should get rid of the death penalty because it costs too much. How? They only paid $83 per dose. That's clearly less money than life imprisonment. And here is proof. Quote, in Massachusetts, it costs $55,170 per prisoner. This is clearly inherent. There is no problem. If it costs $83 per injection, not including case, for both the death penalty and life in jail, that is 0.15% of the cost of keeping someone in prison for life. 0.15%. If we have less appeals, it would be crazy to say that the death penalty costs more money than life in prison. Quote, yet most comparisons of cost of life imprisonment with the cost of life imprisonment with the cost of execution, apart from their dubious relevance, are flawed, at least by the implied assumption that the life imprisoners will relevate no judicial cost during their imprisonment. At any rate, the actual monetary costs are trumped by the importance of doing justice. Ernest Van Den Hogg. The reason why there is so much information that they claim that life imprisonment will be cheaper than the death penalty is because they are taking info that considers that there will be no judicial costs. Their second argument is about that they say that is racist. That is clearly inherent. Quote, the ratio of defendants executed in the U.S. since 1976 is 56% white, 35% black, 7% Hispanic, and 2% other. White people executed is over 21% more than black people. There's a clear difference in how much white people are executed to how much black people are executed. Quote, reading the majority opinion for the Supreme Court Justice, Powell held that the statistical studies on race by themselves were an insufficient bias for overturning the death penalty. deathpenalty.org. The Supreme Court has ruled that race studies were not a reason to overturn the death penalty. They also say that people are innocently convicted, but and they also say that that people are targeted. But quote, these statutes require a two-stage trial procedure in which the jury first determines guilt or innocence and then chooses imprisonment or death in the light of aggravating or mitigating circumstances. The case against the death penalty, ACLU. And then another one says, quote, the innocent can take solace in knowing that a unanimous jury of 12 citizens must render the death verdict after an exhaustive trial where the accused murderer is represented by two highly competent attorneys and overseen by an independent judge who ensures a fair trial. So they say that innocent people, that people are being taken advantage of? Well, clearly not. It's very unlikely that an innocent person or someone taken advantage of is convicted with a unanimous jury of 12, two fabulous attorneys, a completely fair judge, and two trials. So it is clearly inherent. And then quote, there's, quote, however, acknowledging that mistakes can occasionally occur in a capital case does not render the death penalty unjust any more than imposing a sentence of incarceration for a term of years is not rendered unjust simply because mistakes occasionally occur in non-capital cases. Heritage.org. There will be mistakes in every case, but we have made sure that only three people, according to them, has innocently put to death in capital cases. So it is just like life in prison. Putting someone in prison, we have not let one person die innocently under. We have only let three people die innocently under our plan, which will also improve people not dying innocently with DNA testing, eyewitness, or video footage. They also says it doesn't have a deterrent effect, and we believe it does. Quote, Ernest Van Den Haag, the professor of jurisprudence at Fordham University, who has studied the question of deterrence closely, wrote, capital punishment is likely to deter more than any other punishment because people fear death more than anything else. They fear most death deliberately inflicted by law and scheduled by the courts. Whatever people fear most is likely to deter the most. Hence, the threat of the death penalty may deter some murders who otherwise might not have been deterred. Deathpenalty.org. What you fear the most will deter you the most. It is clearly obvious. Quote, using a panel set of over 3,000 countries from 1977 to 1996, Professor Hashem Tesfaye, Paul R. Rubin, and Joanna M. Shepherd of Emory University found that each execution on average resulted in 18 fewer murders. 18 fewer murders, heritage.org. These professors used data out of 3,000 countries, and he found that in fact only one execution resulted in 18 fewer murders, not just crimes, full-out murders. Quote, the majority of studies that track effects over many years and across states or countries find a deterrent effect, deathpenaltyprocon.org. Yet again, we have evidence that a majority of studies show that the death penalty does have a deterrent effect. Quote, punishments which are swift and sure are the best deterrents, deathpenalty.org. There will be a large deterrent effect because with our plan, we will make sure swift trials, which are guaranteed by their constitution, with our evidence, there will be more and more swift trials. Clearly, there's an inherent issue with the deterrent effect. Okay, my partner Keaton already refuted the affirmative plan an advantage, so I'll not be discussing this further. In conclusion, judges, our position is that the penal code should not be abolished for the death penalty. They argue that they want to abolish the death penalty because it costs too much, there is an deterrent effect, innocent people are put to death, there is retribution, it is quote-unquote racist, and that they target people. However, my partner Keaton and I clearly and absolutely showed you how inadequate their arguments were by proving without a doubt that they did not break the stock issue, that they did break the stock issues of inherency, because as we effectively showed you, there are no problems with the current status quo. They argued, we clearly have shown this in a few ways. First off, with the cost, they said we have $83 per dose. That is facts, and they have brought barely any facts to the table. So we have facts that we have this. We show that for one case, which isn't even costing about the judiciary cost, which could amount in much more, that is 0.15% an injection for life imprisonment. We also showed that it isn't racist because over 21% of people that are executed are white. And so clearly it isn't. They also say they're targeting poor people and that they're targeting that innocent people are put to death. But how can this be when a jury of 12 unanimous people, a fair judge, that, and two highly competent jury attorneys that we make sure are good, that they are having a targeting poor people? That sounds ridiculous. They have brought no evidence to the table, and their credentials have serious issues with them. So we vote, we urge the judges to vote for the resolution that the United States should keep it against the resolution that the United States should change its penal code to abolish the death penalty. This obviously matters to the families of the victims who were murdered or they committed heinous crimes against. Thank you.
Speak up, please.
In your did you say that you have no facts or evidence, even though this graph is taken from actual court cases?
Well, you did not enter. You don't have that graph.
So, yes.
You didn't say that graph at all. And also, you showed a graph in your cross-exam that was all about opinions. I don't think. All right.
So, does the death penalty have flaws?
It has some, and that's why we.
Does the death penalty cost too much?
We fully fixed it with our
In one of your quotes, that it costs too much, you said the date was 2011, 9 years ago?
Yep.
9 years is a pretty long time.
Well, I don't know.
Anyway, does the person that you quoted, what is his job?
Amanda Kimberly. She is the president of World Money Watch. She is the economic expert at the author of The Ultimate.
Is the death penalty racist? But, according to the graph taken from actual court cases, there's a boat in persons executed for interracial murders, there are 295 black defendants that were. There are 295 black defendants that were killed, and only 21 that were not killed, no, that were killed. So you're saying it's racist?
Well,
it's not racist?
We're talking about the unanimous jury. He's saying that every unanimous jury, every judge, every person is racist?
So, anyway, in the innocent section, people have died because of the... Innocent people have died.
You're three.
And... did we say that they're being taken advantage of ever in our...
You said that innocent people were taken... You said that poor people are being taken advantage of.
All right. And in your deterrent, was that... do you have any... your quotes, were they opinions or facts?
They were all facts.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Can you repeat one of the quotes real quick?
Using a pale data set of over 2,000 countries. Found that each execution averages up to 18 fewer murders.
Speak up.
Continue to the other quotes in the
There's the majority of slaves that track effects over many years and across states or countries find a deterrent effect.
No, I'm talking about do you have that one about fear?
Yes. Should I finish?
No, he's up.
Oh.